Okay.
There's another tutorial. Today, I will be training my racket using Ashway Kevlar 16 and Monogut ZX.
Can you see that? Yeah. Kevlar and Monogut.
Okay. So I string mine 65 in the main and 55 cross. 10 pound difference. Okay. I'm going to set it to 65 for the main. And then I start. This is how I measure my length. I do about three times like this, but it depends on the people. But for me, it's three and a half, I think. One, two, three, and about half, but maybe four. It's about that much. Same thing for the cross here. This is the Monogut ZX. One, two, three, and a, okay, four. So I do four times. Okay. Put this away, starting with the main. So I start the main. So it depends on the racket. This is 18 by 20, so I start here. Okay. Starting clamp, and I start. You see that?
Yeah.
Okay. Lock it. Power pad. This Kevlar is so easy to string. I mean, this Ashway setup is so good. I love it. So much spin, so much control. So I'm going to even out by doing this side now. I did two here. I'm going to do this now. So I always try to like do a little bit here and a little bit here so we even out the tension. So I've been doing this for almost a year now and getting pretty good at this. So I'm gonna do this side. I usually string mine every 5 session. Although this string almost never breaks, I feel like the playability starts to loosen up. I only change racket when I start to feel like I'm hitting the ball out more. And I'll tell you what I do when I tie off. Okay, so this is 8. Now when I tie off, I increase my tension to 15%. If I add 12 pounds here to my 65, so I go to 75, 77. And then I tie off. So this is the anchor string, over the anchor string, under the anchor string, through. This is the Gamma Star, I'm gonna get one of these. This is a Chinese cheapo. I mean, it still works, but I like this better. So I'm gonna get another one. So this side's done. Working on this side. Yeah, I did it just right. So I measured it 4 times, remember? With my length, my arm length. I did it 4 times. And it's just long enough. You know, this much, so it's alright. I did good. So I did 4 times. Over the anchor string, under the anchor string, through. This is the Wilson Pearl knot. That's what I use. And this Kevlar is so easy to string. Main's done. Cut off the excess here. I just do it with the scissors. It's like a string, but it's so tough. I mean, I haven't broken one yet. Take one out. Adjust my tension to my main, which is 55. 55 here. Just 10 pound difference. So starting my cross. I'm gonna start my cross. And this monogut is so easy to string as well, because the string is so stiff. So I'm gonna give about this much. What is that? Like a foot? My starting clamp. Okay. And I'm working my cross. Make sure I don't burn through the Kevlar. I do it slowly. Make sure these don't kink. Okay, set to 55, starting my cross. I always double check my work. Try to. Up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. make sure these don't kink. Up, down, up, down. As you do more of these, you just get really good. You know? I was pretty bad at first, but now, getting pretty good. I was thinking about getting a electronic tensioner, which is from the Wise, but I'm really happy with this tensioner. It's a lockout, and it's very easy to use. You know, very reliable, and I don't need electricity to do it. You know. 9 more to go. Oops, I missed one. Crap. Good thing I caught that. As time goes on. You know, when you do your crosses, these are not always straight, so I try to make it as straight as possible. Almost there. So as you go towards the end, your string starts to get stiffer because you're towards the end. So you just gotta keep on moving along. good thing about this Ashway hybrid setup is like they just have so much spin and control. That's why I went 5 pounds higher. Where 6 pound, they say the 60 pound is the max, but I went 65 on the main, you know, because I want more control. So it depends on the people. If you want more power, you lower the tension. If you want more control, you up the tension. So I want more control, so I increase the tension. One, two, three more to go. Three more to go. Just focus. Up, down, up, down, up, down. Because the string is so stiff, I just feed it sideways like this. And it's pretty easy. Huh. Missed somewhere. Huh. I missed here. Crap. It's okay. I think I caught that. It happens even when you're paying attention. So you just gotta check your work. Yep, it's good. Thing about this mono gut tie off is that you gotta be really careful when you tie off, because these things break when you make a knot, so you just gotta be really careful with it. When you tie the knot. No angle here. Make it more sharp. Two more. Almost there. Okay, so last one. But I got one more pull, regular pull. And then I'm gonna do a tie off pull, which is 15% increase in tension. Which I will set it to 67. Remember, my cross was 55. So I'm increasing it by 12 pounds, which is 15% around, roughly. Missed it again one more time. It always happens towards the end, so you gotta be really vigilant. There it is. Fairway Hills and the award-winning Hobbits Glen provide enough challenges boom, boom, to captivate boom. The weekend novice or the seasoned pro. Become a CEO. Now doing my last pull before I increase my tension. There it is. That's my last 55. Now I'm going to increase my tension to 67 for my tie off. Five, one, two, 67. Mm-hmm. Wow, I have leftover. Okay. Now my final tie off. That's too much. I'm gonna cut off. So even if you have the little bit of slack, it compensates. That extra 12 pounds compensates the slack. But notice how I pull here. I'm like very gentle, so I don't break that knot. Even if I do the 2-point, I'm very like gentle with it, because if you pull too hard on this monogut, it'll break. So I'm like very gentle with it. You know? I'm gonna pull it here one more time. Finally tie off this end, and that completes my string job over the anchor string, under the anchor string, and through. And I'm gonna do two pulls, make sure there's no slack, and be very careful when you pull this monogut, because you will break it towards the end. You don't want to break it when you're towards the end, so you gotta be really like careful with it. Voila! There it is, folks. And that's how you do a Kevlar in the main and monogut ZX in the cross. tensioned at 65 in the mains, 55 in the cross.